Okay.
Just a little bit.
Okay. I'm in the danger zone.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, everyone. It's Emily Welsh here at the Kansas City Zoo, and we're looking at the hippo today here, Liberty. She's having a snack right now. She is an amazing creature. She walked right over here as soon as Shelly, our zookeeper, brought the bucket of fruit over. She knew it was snack time. Do you do this every day?
She does it every day, Memorial Day through Labor Day. And at 10 a.m.,
wow.
She always gets a snack, and she typically comes out of her pool for everyone to see her, too.
Yeah, she knew it was snack time. She walked right up out of the water, right over here, and the noises are just hilarious that you can hear her, like, chewing it. And so I don't even know if she chews it. Probably just swallows it.
So she is chewing it. She has molars in the back of her mouth, and she is sucking on all of these fruits and kind of mashing them up. And making kind of like a smoothie out of them in the back of the mouth.
I can see it in there now.
Yes. Okay. Good girl.
You just toss it right in.
We do.
Oh my goodness. So what can you tell us about the teeth? I mean, it looks like she's just got a few real big ones in there.
So she does have two sets of teeth. So she has, I'm going to have her open. She has these incisors in the front and then Liberty open. And then she has molars in the back.
I see them.
Which is what she actually chews with. Open.
Okay.
The incisors in the front continuously grow. And then she has 36 teeth total.
Wow.
But the incisors in the front don't really serve any purpose. They're kind of just for show. And then the molars in the back are what she actually chews with. And she would chew her grasses and fruits with.
Okay. So other than the fruit, what do hippos eat? I mean, she's huge. You would think she has to eat a lot in a day.
So she is a strict herbivore. They feed at dusk. So they'll leave the water around dusk, travel up to about 5 to 6 miles, and they eat about 150 pounds of different types of grasses every day.
Wow. So how many times a day? Just at night is
just
when you'll
at
feed
night.
Them?
Yeah.
They all of that
feed
grass.
Typically at night. Here at the Kansas City Zoo, we feed them, she gets alfalfa, hay, and then grain.
Oh my goodness.
She gets fed in the morning out here on her island, and then at night she gets fed up in her bedroom.
Okay, so where's her bedroom? Where does
her
she go?
Her bedroom is right behind us here. So she has access to her chute, and she can follow that up, and it goes into the crocodile and hippo building.
Okay, so she can get away from the public if
yeah,
she wants to.
Yeah, she can go back up kind of behind the scenes so people can't see her. But
yeah.
She typically hangs out in the water all day just because it's easier for her with all the weight that she has to carry around on those short little legs.
Yeah, so do they kind of float in there? Are they good swimmers?
They actually are more dense in water, so they don't swim when they're fully grown. They actually walk on the bottoms of the lakes and the rivers in which they live. So they can swim when they're young, but once they become fully grown, they are too dense. They will just walk on the bottom of the lakes and the rivers.
Okay, so she's just walking. Now, I read this morning, I wanted to ask if this is true, that they can have bursts of speed where they can get up to like 18 miles an hour.
Yeah, so they
can actually
run about 30 miles an hour
for
very short distances.
Oh, my gosh.
And on average, they do about 18 to 25. And then
in
the water, they can swim about, they can walk in the water about 8 miles an hour.
Wow. So, I mean, have you ever seen her run? I just can't imagine this giant beast
run
going so fast.
A couple times, but not really run. It's more of like she was just kind of trotting up and down the chute. She was ready for dinner.
Yeah, yeah. She was getting impatient.
Yeah, she was hungry.
Yeah. Oh, that is incredible.
They do have webbed feet, though, because when they are young, they're born about 75 pounds, 75 to 100 pounds when they are born, and they will swim until they become adults. So they do have webbed feet.
Oh,
four toes, webbed feet.
Yeah, I'm looking at her feet right now. And I read that they're related to whales.
They are related to whales. That are those are their closest relatives.
I mean, looking at her, I guess you can kind of see it, even though she's
I'm not exactly sure how it all works out. Open. Good girl. But
that
she
view.
Loves her fruit. She loves the grasses that we feed her here as well. Her favorite fruits are probably bananas and grapes. She really loves bananas. Anything that has a lot of juice to it.
I felt that.
Anything that has a lot of juice to it, she loves. Hi, Miss May.
She's loving the camera right now. I mean,
I know,
she's posing.
She says, get my close up.
Yeah, get my good side.
You funny, Mama. You want
Wow.
Open.
So since she's so big, I mean, does she have to stay in the water to keep cool also? I would imagine she gets pretty hot out here.
She does stay in the water for most of the day to help her keep cool. Her body naturally produces something called blood sweat, and it is what they secrete off of their skin, and it keeps them from getting sunburnt in the water if their backs are poking out of the top, mm-hmm. and it helps them if they ever wound themselves. Mm. It helps heal those wounds, so it's really great, and they naturally produce it.
Interesting. So what are the whiskers in the front? I mean, what's the mm-hmm. what are their purpose?
So the whiskers up here on her face, those she has hair on her
more.
Ears, her nose, and she has a little bit on her back. The hairs, she'll wiggle her ear hairs to get water out of her ears. It's called waggling her ears, so you'll see them come up out of the water and they'll waggle their ears. But the hairs on top of their faces, it just helps them feel around better. They don't have hands that they're able to use like we can. And so they'll use those hairs on the front of their face to feel where they are, to make sure they're mm-hmm. not going to run into something. They don't have the best of vision, so those hairs really help them navigate.
So we have people watching on Facebook Live right now and asking some questions. So okay. Avery is asking, how much do they weigh?
So hippos, females weigh about 3,000 to 4,000 pounds, and males will weigh about 6,000 to 7,000 pounds.
Ooh.
So they'll weigh about twice as much as a female hippo.
Oh, my gosh. Mm-hmm. It's crazy to think of how they can move.
Yes, they are very, very large, but they are very agile for having all that weight.
Yeah. You mentioned they're 75 pounds when they're born, uh-huh. the baby. So how many do they have at a time? Just one?
So they can have twins, but it's very rare.
Okay.
They typically only have one. They'll nurse for about 10 to 12 months, but they will stay with their moms for about 6 to 7 years.
Oh, wow.
They can.
Okay. How long is it that you said they stay in the water when they're young? How long before they come out?
I know that the mother will kind of separate herself from their school, is what the groups of hippos are called, schools, for about 2 weeks prior and 2 weeks after she has her baby, just uh-huh. because she's very protective. She wants to bond with her baby, make sure everything's okay. And then they will join the school, and they protect each other because when they're young is the only time they actually have any type of predators.
Yeah, and kind of going off of that, they're a very dangerous animal. Even mm-hmm. though you might look at them and think that they're big or slow.
Will you grab this for me?
Sorry. Oh, yeah, we're going to get her some more snacks.
Yeah, they are very large
because she
animals.
Is asking
they're
for
one
more.
Of the most deadly animal in Africa behind the mosquito.
Oh, wow. Big difference.
They're very territorial over their feeding grounds, and they're very territorial over their water and young. Come here, Mama.
So they're pretty aggressive, okay. right? I mean, you
yes,
said territorial.
They're very
like, they'll
aggressive.
Come at you.
Uh-huh. They will charge. They will tip boats over. So those are like the main forms of transportation in the areas in which you find hippos for mm-hmm. humans. But really their only natural predator when they're young are crocodiles and in general just humans.
Mm-hmm. But they are extremely dangerous. Even
yes,
when she
they
just
are.
Blows out, I can feel it.
Oh, yeah,
the
you
breath.
Can feel the breath come out of her. Uh-huh.
She's loving the fruit.
Yes.
It's so funny. After you stop, she keeps opening her mouth like mm-hmm. more.
She's like,
more.
Is there more?
More. Yeah. I know there's a watermelon up there, too.
Yes. Are you ready for the watermelon?
I think. I think that's going to be,
let me grab
I think
that
she'll
for
be
her.
Excited.
Yes, she will be very excited.
All right. Hi. Going to get your watermelon now. Oh, she's ready for it. Open it up wide. You're going to have to open up wider. There's the big guy.
All right.
Here we go.
So I'm going to ask her for her to put her head up. So we do some training with Liberty. We do training here at the zoo just so that if she were to injure herself or become sick and our vet needed to get eyes on her, we can position her how we need to for him to evaluate her and treat her appropriately. So we practice training with him, and she knows a few behaviors. We're still working on a few others, but we always ask her for her head up when we give her a watermelon, because if we don't, she usually drops it and smashes it on the ground. So
that's no good.
Liberty, you ready? Head up. All the way. Good girl. Open. Ready?
Whoa.
You got it? You gotta crush it.
There we go. Ooh. Wow. Powerful. So is this like a special treat? She doesn't usually get a watermelon.
It is very, it's a very watery fruit. And she loves it because she gets a lot of juice from it.
Uh-huh. Going at it. And she just crushes it with those front teeth, kind of like smashes it down.
So they can open their mouths about 150 degrees. So humans can only open their mouths about 45 degrees.
So it can be wider than her open
their, yeah, they can open their mouths very wide.
Wow.
But she loves getting watermelons. We give her pumpkins. She can have honeydew, cantaloupe. Melons are probably definitely her favorite, though.
Yeah, I just love watching her eat it. You can see how much she's enjoying it. Mm-hmm. So you said she's 32 years old, you said earlier. How long do hippos live?
So their average lifespan in the wild is about 36 years. Wow. In captivity, they can live longer, around 40 years. I think the oldest one on record was in his 50s or 60s.
Wow. Wow. So she is 32, so she's getting up there for a hippo. And I know she used to have a friend here with her. Are hippos generally kind of solitary?
She might get upset about that, yeah. So they're very territorial over their food, and especially when they're feeding.
Can't get in the way of the watermelon.
Sometimes she'll drop some fruit, and I'll try to help her, and she doesn't want it. She's very territorial.
Don't take that from me.
She says, excuse me.
She's making sure you're not going to get in the way.
Yes.
It's okay. I don't want any. You can have it all.
She really ate that fast.
Yeah.
You are not wasting any time.
She was eyeing it up there. But do they generally, I know you said they are in schools, but are they kind of solitary creatures in general?
No, they live in groups in schools. Yep, they can have around 100 hippos in a school.
Okay, wow.
And there'll be dominant males and then more subordinate males and then females. But typically they'll have their females that they breed with.
Okay, and they were asking again how old she is.
She's 32 years old.
Okay, 32.
Yep, her birthday was 2 weeks ago.
Oh, happy belated birthday,
It was middle of July.
Liberty.
That's why her name's Liberty.
Oh, love
that. It's because she's named after the 4th of July.
Someone else was asking what was wrong with her nose, or she kind of has the little...
She's
Squint
had
there.
That. It's just a scrape from when she was younger. She's had that since she came to us in 1995.
Yeah. So she's all That's right.
That's actually how we distinguish the two of our hippos apart from each other, because they do look very similar to each other. We always knew Liberty as the one with the pink spot on her nose.
Yeah.
And Labor Day just had her solid brown nose.
Okay. And we had one more question from Evelyn, or from... Sarah, is the zoo hoping to get her a friend, a companion? I know she used to have one.
I don't know. Liberty's on the older side of hippos, and I don't know how she would take to a new friend.
Okay, so she
at
might
this
be
point,
territorial.
She's probably, you Setting know, just kind of, you know, enjoying her retirement.
Gotcha. Okay, so for now, she'll hang out here. Mm-hmm. So she's going to finish up her snack time. But thank you so much, Shelley, for talking to us
welcome.
And teaching us all about Liberty. This has been so much fun. Thanks to all our viewers for watching on our KMBC 9 News Facebook page. And you can see some more later on in our newscast. Thanks for stopping by, guys.
You did great. Sorry, I should have probably told you that. She is very funny.